I'm back with another couple of memory reviews for y'all. But before that, it is, as I'm recording this, 4:24 on July the 6th. So that means, at least to me, that it is my little sister's birthday. And people will hear that and think, wait, I know he had an older sister, but he had a little one too. Yeah, this one ain't blood, we ain't related in no type of way. But we always kind of had each other back ever since we met each other, and it's her birthday, so. Amy, happy birthday. Hope you enjoy it. Hope it's good to you. Wish you were still here, but I understand that, life goes on and things in Tennessee are probably better than they are here. So, happy birthday. Hope you enjoy it. Wish you were here. It's been too long. You need to really fix that. And now that I got the birthday wishes out of the way, we're gonna take a look at the Power Rangers movie and the Marine 5. Now, when I say the Power Ranger movie, you're probably thinking you could be talking about the one from 95, or the one from 97, or the one that just came out. In this case, I'm talking about the one that just came out. So we'll start with that one first. Now, I didn't really know what to expect coming into this as an updated, Power Rangers movie. Most movies these days that are remakes anyway aren't really able to stand up to the originals, and this one I think oddly does stand up to the original. Basically, there's this crystal that Rangers need to protect to save the Earth from Rita Repulsa getting in and basically ending life on the planet. And it's so it's the basic story, same basic story, but it still holds up. Even, made modern. The thing about this one is, the characters were, very different. In the TV show and the previous two movies, they were all kind of cast as, the goody-goody types. In this particular case, each one of the Rangers had, their own specific dark challenges, and the way this movie started out, I got a serious Breakfast Club vibe, which, again, not a bad thing. One of my favorite movies ever, so not a bad thing. It just kind of up the cool points for me, but I thought the special effects were done really well. I thought the acting was done really well. I thought the character I liked the most in a movie, actually, I thought it was gonna be Zordon, played by Bryan Cranston, but actually, I found myself, effing and chuckling at, Alpha being the, because Alpha, being the smart ass, because, even in the TV show and the first couple movies, the, he was on a much more cleaned up scale, the smart ass of the group. So, they stuck to that, and were able to kind of take some liberties because of the updating of the movie. But this really did have a, kind of a Breakfast Club feel to it, to me. And like I said, that's not a bad thing. I would definitely recommend seeing this one, picking it up. Go ahead and give it 4.5 out of 5. And we're gonna move to the Marine 5, which is the 5th in WWE Studio Marine franchise. And the 3rd, yeah, it's the 3rd, with Miz in the lead role, and he does very well in these movies. Truth be told, anything with a WWE Studios tag on it, I will get, just because I want to collect everything done by WWE Studios. Matter of fact, there are a couple more I have, still have to get yet, but it stands up. I enjoyed it for what it was, and I kind of knew what it was going to be because I know what the franchise is. You know, it's basically a fight, like, explosions and a lot of physical action, which is very entertaining to me, and I enjoy. Basically what this is Miz's character, not a Marine anymore, he has graduated being an EMT, and for whatever reason he has to protect this guy from a biker gang of all things. And it just, it calls on, all of his Marine training, and he basically has to go back into Marine mode because, heroes save the day. I thought it was, like I said, I enjoyed it for what it was. It was cheesy, I admit, but I like cheesy movies sometimes. So, and of course Naomi, Curtis Axel, Bo Dallas and Maurice all play roles in the movie, and so yeah, I very much enjoyed it. I would definitely tell y'all, this one is definitely worth picking up, or at least looking to see if it's on Netflix or Amazon or any other streaming service you may use. I'm gonna go ahead and give this one 3.5 really out of 5, and say, well done. It was a cheesy movie. I expected it to be, and I enjoyed it for what it was. So 3.5 wheelies for Marine 5, and 4.5 wheelies for Power Rangers. See both, find both, watch both, enjoy both. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Thanks for, offering the creativity. Without y'all, I couldn't do what I do. So I appreciate you very, very much. I'll be back for you later. And until then, I love y'all.